Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 8, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we all cross the finish line together. First article of interest. Abdul Mahdi's office. The actions that accompanied. The demonstrations are not for democratic practices. 8 November, 2019 Baghdad. Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi's office said Friday that the demonstrations were unrelated to democratic practices. A statement from the office of Abdul Mahdi transferred television official said that the demonstrations were accompanied by acts of criminal and terrorist and are clearly visible in order to undermine the prestige of the state and weaken its capabilities in targeting the people of Iraq and its security. He added that these actions has not been to the relevance of democratic practices, such as murder against citizens and security forces or right. The crime of threatening to commit a felony against innocent citizens and security forces is punishable by imprisonment for a period not exceeding 7 years, the statement said. The crime of assault, injury or violence against innocent citizens and security forces is punishable by imprisonment for a period not exceeding 1 year. He stressed that the crime of preventing state employees from carrying out their job duties is punishable by imprisonment for a period not exceeding 3 years. He explained that the crime of sabotage, demolition, destruction or fraud of buildings or public property allocated to the departments or government departments or public facilities or state facilities, including transport and bridges, their penalties are severe. The statement pointed out that the crime of burning the homes of innocent citizens and the headquarters of the security forces and official and semi-official departments is punishable by life imprisonment or temporary, adding that the crime of incitement and encouragement with financial assistance to sabotage or damage to buildings or government services or public facilities punishable by imprisonment for a period of no more than 20 years. He pointed out that the crime of violating the orders issued by the competent authorities, including the imposition of curfews at the specified times, punishable by imprisonment, stressing that the crime of assaulting the security forces located within the areas and yards of the demonstration and the penalty of imprisonment. The statement continued, the crime of broadcasting rumors, propaganda and false news in various public ways to sow terror in the hearts of citizens punishable by imprisonment, pointing out that the crime of incitement in public ways not to comply with the law in force. The statement called on the demonstrators to adhere to peaceful demonstrations to demand legitimate rights so that the state can implement them and reject the acts criminalized by Iraqi law and cooperate with security to arrest the abusive elements. The statement called on the demonstrators to maintain the peacefulness of the demonstrations and give a bright and bright image to miss the opportunity on the donors and Iraq evil, noting that the state is committed to take legal action against the perpetrators of the crimes mentioned. Next article of interest. Barzani reveals the figures on what the Kurdistan region receives from the federal budget. 8 November, 2019 Kurdistan. The president of the Kurdistan Regional Government, Masrur Barzani, revealed details regarding the proportion of the region of the federal budget. Barzani said in a statement that the federal budget depends on the number of oil exports estimated at 4.5 million barrels per day, while Iraq exports about 3 million barrels per day, and the rest is allocated for domestic consumption, which is estimated at 1.5 million barrels, of which the region does not receive anything, which is that represents 22% of the budget, and deduct the sovereign budget, amounting to 45%, of which the region does not have a share. In addition to reducing the share of the region of the budget, which is 17%, out of 12.6% agreed, indicating that those figures it means that ICLM receives a calculated share of 12.6% out of 55% of the total 78% of the actual budget, so the real figure is 5% of the federal budget. Next article of interest. Barzani hopes to restore security and stability in Iraq. 8 November 2019 1836 Kurdistan. The head of the Kurdistan Regional Government Masrur Barzani, on Friday, Congratulations to Muslims in Kurdistan, Iraq, and the world by the anniversary of the birth of the Prophet. On the occasion of the anniversary of the birth of the Prophet, I extend my sincere congratulations to the Muslims in Kurdistan, Iraq, and the world, hoping that this blessed occasion will be an opportunity to flourish and strengthen the bonds of peaceful coexistence in Kurdistan and the establishment of security and stability in Iraq and the region. The KRG decided to suspend official working hours on Saturday. Next article of interest. U.S. report. Iran considers Abdul Mahdi's government as its government and does not want to lose. 8 November, 2019 Iraq. The protests in Iraq are the largest in decades, threatening both Baghdad and Tehran, the Washington Post reported, adding that the streets of Baghdad are not alien to power struggles, but this time the crowds are different, and they represent the largest popular movement in Iraq's modern history. A new generation grew up under the U.S. invasion, and politicians from Baghdad and Tehran now find themselves defending their powers. The newspaper pointed in a report to a banner held high in the central Baghdad square read, "To the generations of the 60s and 70s, we encourage you," referring to these protests are new in everything. Threat to the equation of governance. Hareth Hassan, a non-resident scholar at the Carnegie Endowment for Near East Studies, said the most important thing these protests do is threaten the sectarian equation that has reduced Iraqis to their ethnic and religious identities. The newspaper reported that Iran, frightened by the elimination of its influence, intervened to impose a brutal response to the protests. It said Tehran had pressed Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi, who had prepared his resignation, to give up his resignation and convinced him that the protests were a foreign plot run by the United States and Israel. "No to the militias and religious doctrines," it quoted a 19-year-old protester, whose first name was Muhammad, as saying they wanted a government free of militias and religious doctrine. On the reluctance of Iraqis in the west and north of the country to participate in the protests, the newspaper said they believe that the government will use their participation to say they want to return fighters of the Islamic State. The Washington Post continued to talk about the Iraqi protests, saying it surprised the political elites and many Iraqis. Concerning Iran's fear of these protests, the Washington Post said Tehran regards Abdul Mahdi's government as its own and believes it has for the first time succeeded in controlling decision-making, so it does not want to lose that government easily. Next article of interest. Urgent Pompeo, we must help the people of Iraq and achieve their aspirations. 8 November 2019 1352 Germany, we must help the people of Iraq and Lebanon and achieve their aspirations, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said. Our soldiers are in Syria and we want Europe to join us to help the Kurds, Pompeo said at a forum in Germany. There are hundreds of terrorists in Syria who want to be tried in their countries. We will do our best to return 6 million Syrians to their homes and we will work through the Security Council by issuing a resolution on this matter, he said. Next article of interest. Exclusive. Iran moves missiles to Iraq in warning to enemies. 8 November 2019 Paris/Baghdad, Reuters. Iran has given ballistic missiles to Shiite proxies in Iraq and is developing the capacity to build more there to deter attacks on its interests in the Middle East and to give it the means to hit regional foes, Iranian, Iraqi and Western sources said. Any sign that Iran is preparing a more aggressive missile policy in Iraq will exacerbate tensions between Tehran and Washington, already heightened by U.S. President Donald Trump's decision to pull out of a 2015 nuclear deal with world powers. It would also embarrass France, Germany and the United Kingdom, the three European signatories to the nuclear deal, as they have been trying to salvage the agreement despite new U.S. sanctions against Tehran. According to three Iranian officials, two Iraqi intelligence sources and two Western intelligence sources, Iran has transferred short-range ballistic missiles to allies in Iraq over the last few months. Five of the officials said it was helping those groups to start making their own. The logic was to have a backup plan if Iran was attacked, one senior Iranian official told Reuters. The number of missiles is not high, just a couple of dozen, but it can be increased if necessary. Iran has previously said its ballistic missile activities are purely defensive in nature. Iranian officials declined to comment when asked about the latest moves. The Iraqi government and military both declined to comment. The Zalzal, Fateh 110 and Zulfikar missiles in question have ranges of about 200 km to 700 km, putting Saudi Arabia's capital Riyadh or the Israeli city of Tel Aviv within striking distance if the weapons were deployed in southern or western Iraq. The Quds Force, the overseas arm of Iran's powerful Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, IRGC, has bases in both those areas. Quds Force Commander Qasem Soleimani is overseeing the program, three of the sources said. Western countries have already accused Iran of transferring missiles and technology to Syria and other allies of Tehran, such as Houthi rebels in Yemen and Lebanon's Hezbollah. Iran's Sunni Muslim Gulf neighbors and its archenemy Israel have expressed concerns about Tehran's regional activities, seeing it as a threat to their security. Israeli officials did not immediately respond to requests for comment about the missile transfers. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said on Wednesday that anybody that threatened to wipe Israel out would put themselves in a similar danger. Next article of interest. A spokesman for Abdul Mahdi holds demonstrators losing $6 billion. 8 November 2019 1520 Iraq. Major General Abdul Karim Khalif, spokesman for the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi, revealed the losses suffered in Iraq due to the recent events in the country from 1 October. Khalif said in a press statement, the impediments that occurred in the export and import operations through the port of Umm Qasr and affected the sale of oil due to the recent events of Iraq, caused losses to the country up to $6 billion U.S. dollars, but the government seeks to compensate those losses. He added that the operations of sale, purchase, export and import stopped as a result of the event of obstruction and obstruction of the institutions of the Iraqi state and stop its work. Next article of interest. A member of the Stream of Wisdom, the demonstrations caused political shock and accelerated reforms. 8 November 2019 1317 Iraq. A member of the Executive Office of the National Wisdom Movement, Haider Sultan, that the demonstrations precipitated reforms. Sultan told the Euphrates News that peaceful youth demonstrator and stationed in Tahrir Square caused shock to the political class. He pointed out that these demonstrations precipitated political, executive and legislative reforms and judicial procedures did not see the light of 10 years and more. The protests in Iraq entered its third week on Friday, marking the fall of more wounded martyrs due to clashes between security forces and demonstrators in the demonstration yards in Baghdad and the southern provinces. Next article of interest. Economist. The government condemned itself by declaring the size of the losses due to the closure of the port of Umm Qasr. 10:30, 8 November 2019 Baghdad. Economic expert Osama Al-Tamimi said on Friday that the government condemned itself and put many questions about its statements about Iraq's losses due to the closure of the port of Umm Qasr and other institutions during the demonstrations. Tamimi said in a statement to the information that the border outlets are controlled by political parties, where their revenues are divided according to specific ratios between those parties. He added that the government's announcement of the size of the losses due to the closure of the port of Umm Qasr and other institutions since the start of the demonstration confirms that the amount of funds in Iraq much larger than the government announced in the budget, and therefore the size of corruption is very large and fictitious amounts are not mentioned. He explained that the government condemned itself when it announced the magnitude of the losses and showed the truth of the amounts in Iraq, while the budget represents a fraction of these amounts, which go mostly to the corrupt, what requires the prime minister to be honest with the people and declare the corrupt names that capture the amounts of Iraq. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like and the subscribe button and check out the SEP currency exchange planner. The link is in the description panel below. Make sure to tell them that Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.